sucks and scandalous move from a guard pass. Okay, and so I say scandalous because Michael and I are wearing gis, and to make it even better, Michael's a four-tip white belt, and we're going to be doing a heel hook today. So apply this, drill it, gi, no gi. We are, at our academy, we're always talking about rules, sport, self-defense. We don't just do jiu-jitsu for sport, but we do a lot of sport. And we also do a lot of no-gi, so I train the heel hooks and all the leg locks, gi and no-gi, and for the most part, except for some of our super younger competitors, that hasn't been an issue with turning that switch off in a tournament. I would like to personally see heel hooks be legal in the gi for adult black belt within the next 5 years. And that may or may not happen due to liabilities and things of that nature, but we're going to be doing a slick little heel hook option. I think it's a bad idea to fall backwards on leg locks when you're passing the guard. I've had that burn me a few times in competition where people stood up on me. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go for my standard windshield wiper pass. I'm just going to do a guard break, go that same side knee across. Michael's going to counter by going a shin across my belly, like a scissor sweep type attempt. He's really just using that to kind of block my path. He switched a back step pass there normally. It was kind of unorthodox, and I don't fall backwards on this. It's the key thing when I teach this, I always try and drive home. I fall to my side and stop him from coming up with me, okay? So I'm going to be in Michael's closed guard here. I'm just going to do a simple posture break. I roll those hips up. I start to work that. Yes, okay, right here. And from here, I would either choose, okay, how do I want to pass? I want to go into the head. What is my options on how to get around this? And like I said, typically I like to go back set, or I'll maybe switch across here and go under the head, maybe a single under off of this. But the shin is a bad thing that's happening. Feet are together in the back, so you couldn't half guard me. So what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to go to my hip. I'm going to go that leg on top. This is creating lateral pressure. This is part of the illegal part. And I'm going to hook. Catch his toes in my armpit. I hook this wrist bone to the seal. I grip those hands together. And I'm going to twist his foot like a pickle jar this way down this line. And then I'm going to go over at the end. Okay, so here I'll do the knee in the center right now. Here, remember not to pitch forward, more to come up when you do that. Roll that over. He does that there, and sometimes you even lose your base. So just go with it. On my side. And if you fall back, straight back, he might just come up with you. Then you're going to have to try and re-sweep, and it's not efficient. Okay, so, again, scandalous, I know, but fun nonetheless, and study all moves. Doesn't matter if it's takedowns, leg locks, guard pulls. Don't have a closed mind, study it all. Doesn't matter what uniform you're wearing. You want to be able to defend yourself, you want to be knowledgeable, you want to be able to help those no-gi people when you come to that class. So always be thinking about everything. And be thinking about the rules too. And be thinking about your etiquette. We won't be a good teammate, we don't hurt anybody. And I think the best way to do that is start to indoctrinate our younger generation, adults, on how to do leg locks properly. That's been one of the biggest things that's changed in jiu-jitsu since I got in and started training, is the leg lock game. And how many people are going to that, and how much of a threat it can present when you get those 2-, 3-, and 4-year students starting to compete more seriously in no-gi, or they're doing gi and no-gi at the tournaments. You want them to have this piece. It's like a wrist lock at blue belt. It's the first thing you get. But a whole lot of people don't train wrist locks at white belt. If they go to blue belt, they're not getting submitted, because not a lot of people train wrist locks typically. We do. I've had several blue belts get wrist lock submissions in competition. So train for that next level. You don't want to become a brown belt. You can do knee bars and calf crushers and things of that nature, bicep slicers, and then you're a white belt at it because you didn't study it because it was illegal. The rules have changed several times since I've been training. They're going to change again. So be ready if they do. If they do it's ever legal, cool. You can then now do it in deep competition. If it stays illegal, you're lethal, and if nothing else, they're able to defend and know what's going on. If you ever do that WD tournament, once he looks illegal, which 2, 3, 4 year mark, you're going to be looking at bouncing in on all those leg locks. Straight ankle, white belt move. Great follow up, the heel hook. So, guys, thanks for checking out the guard pass. The guard pass to a leg lock. Always be thinking about what our scenarios are when you pass the guard. It's a pin, it's a submission, it's a back take. How did you get in there? Did you escape mount? Did you get a takedown? Did they replace your guard from side mount? What are your entries? What are your scenarios? And be drilling under that kind of lens. All right? Thank you, guys.